Question number 6 of exercise 13.3. The question is, there are 3 coins. Okay. One is a two-headed coin. Okay, the two-headed coin means that that coin is going to have head on both the faces. Another is a biased coin that comes up with heads 75% of the time. Okay, so another is a biased coin in which whenever we are going to toss that coin, we are going to get 75% of the time's head. And a third is an unbiased coin, that it is a normal coin in which we can get head or a tail, and both these events would be equally likely. Now, one of the three coins is chosen at random and tossed. Okay, and it shows head. So what we are doing, we are choosing one of the coin randomly and we are tossing it. And the outcome is a head. What is the probability that it was a two-headed coin? Okay. So in this question, what we have to do, we have to find the probability of choosing a two-headed coin given that the coin shows head. Okay. Now, to further solve the problem, we assume that E1 be the event of choosing a two-headed coin, E2 be the event of choosing a biased coin, E3 be the event of choosing an unbiased coin, and A be the event that head is obtained on tossing. Okay, so these are the events which we have assumed. Okay, now probability of E1 would be equal to 1 by 3, probability of E2 would be equal to 1 by 3, and probability of E3 would be equal to 1 by 3, because probability that we have selected a two-headed coin would be equal to 1 by 3 because there are 3 coins and favorable outcome is 1. So probability of E1 would be equal to 1 by 3. Similarly, E2 is a probability of choosing a biased coin. There are 3 coins and 1 coin is a biased. So probability of E2 would be equal to 1 by 3. And similarly, probability of E3 would be equal to 1 by 3. And what we have to calculate? We have to calculate the probability of E1 given A. Okay. We have to calculate the conditional probability of choosing a two-headed coin given that the head is obtained on tossing. Okay, so to solve this, we are going to apply the Bayes theorem, and according to the Bayes theorem, the probability of E1 given A is equal to probability of E1 into probability of A given E1 whole upon probability of E1 into probability of A given E1 plus probability of E2 into probability of A given E2 plus probability of E3 into probability of A given E3. Okay, so we have to calculate these three probabilities: probability of A given E1, probability of A given E2, and probability of A given E3. Right? So, probability of A given E1. This would mean that the coin shows a head. That is the probability that the coin shows a head given that two-headed coin is selected. So, this would be equal to 1 because the coin is two-headed, it would be 100%, it would be a sure event, it would be 100% sure that the head is always be obtained. So the probability of A given E1 would be equal to 1. Probability of A given E2 would be probability that the coin shows a head given that the biased coin is selected. So because the biased coin shows head 75% of the time, so 75% probability means 75 upon 100 or 3 upon 4. So probability of A given E2 would be equal to 3 upon 4. And probability of A given E3 would be equal to the probability that coin shows a head given that an unbiased coin is selected would be equal to 1 by 2. Because there are 2 outcomes and favorable outcome is 1. So probability of A given E3 would be equal to 1 by 2. And both the events of getting head and tail are equally likely. Okay, so by using Bayes theorem, we can write probability of E1 given A is equal to probability of E1 into probability of A given E1, that is equal to 1. Probability of E1 into probability of A given E1, again 1. Probability of E2 into probability of A given E2 plus probability of E3 into probability of A given E3. Now we can cancel this 1 by 3, 1 by 3, 1 by 3 throughout. And this can be written like this: 1 upon 1 plus 3 by 4 plus 1 by 2. On taking LCM, we are going to get this term, and this can be simplified as equal to 4 upon 9, which is the required answer. So that's how we are going to solve this question. Friends, thanks for watching my video. To watch more of these super videos and for the latest updates, subscribe and like the videos on these channels on YouTube, HSK Shiksha. and math help by HSK. Thank you.